Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss about the space harmonics in synchronous machines. The space harmonics happens mainly due to the non-sinusoidal flux distribution. We know that the EMF induced depends on what is the shape of the waveform or what is the shape of the flux. We know the EMF induced E is equal to d phi by dt. So this d phi by dt, what is the shape of the flux decides what is the shape of the EMF that is produced. If flux is sinusoidal, then automatically your EMF also will be sinusoidal. If flux is non-sinusoidal, automatically the differentiation changes the waveform, you will produce the different kind of the EMF equation. That's why I want always my flux should be sinusoidal. But practically, if you take any alternator, let us take the alternator. So there will be poles. Let us assume this is my north pole and this is my south pole. And on the stator, there will be slotting. Like this, slottings will be there throughout your rotor. So now what happens, you can see here, at this point the gap is more, at this point gap is less, at this point gap is more. So this is happening because of the slotting of the stator. That means, so first reason is stator slotting. Because of stator slotting, this MMF divided by reluctance, which gives your flux, the reluctance is changing, so automatically flux will change. So this we have seen already, that we have termed by the name as slot harmonics. These things we have discussed in last class. Now there is another reasons also due to which the harmonics can come. These harmonics comes because of this field winding. So whatever winding is made, let us assume the flux is coming out from this. This flux, if you are not keeping the shape of your field winding properly, then the flux will not be sinusoidal. It may become some flat topped wave or this type of shape. Because the reason is, at the pole center, the MMF will be very high because the flux will go on adding. So it may get saturated and it becomes the flat top. This can be one reason. And second reason is, there is second type of rotor where is the wound rotor. In the case of wound rotor, again slotting will be there. Due to the slottings only the EMF will be produced. Due to the slotting of the rotor also, the flux distribution becomes non-uniform. Again there also it becomes, MMF will goes on increasing and MMF reaches a peak, it gets saturated. After that again it becomes decreasing. So this component I can resolve into multiple frequency components. This will have the fundamental component plus third harmonic component plus fifth harmonic component, etc. That means this can be resolved as a sum of E1 plus E3 plus E5 plus E7 plus, etc. So out of this, fundamental component is the component that is required for us. Now third harmonic component will be suppressed due to our connection diagram. We have seen during the slot harmonics also, because if you are connecting your winding in the star connection or the delta connection, so that will suppress your third harmonic component in the line. So that we are not worried. So our major concern is about the fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic, these components. Or the harmonics that are produced can be written in the form of 6k plus or minus 1. This is the order of the space harmonics, where k is an integer, so which is 1, 2, 3, etc., which is an integer. So these are the order of the harmonics. So you can substitute here. If you substitute k is equal to 1, this becomes 6 minus 1 is 5 and 6 plus 1 is 7. If you are substituting 2, it becomes 11, 13 and so on. So these are the order. So now, what does this harmonics do? Whatever happens, so like if you are taking your main fundamental flux, so your flux wave, I am telling it is a flat topped wave. This flat topped wave will be the sum of the fundamental flux wave plus the sum of the third harmonic, fourth harmonic, fifth harmonic, like that, the sum of the multiple frequency components lead to this. That means, let us take for example this one. So here you can see, this has completed one cycle, this has completed two cycles. In half cycle, this has completed two cycles. That means, it is producing how many poles? In the distance of one pole, this is producing four poles. I am just taking the example of any one example. So similarly, if you take the third harmonic means in one pole, it will have three poles. Similarly, fifth harmonic will have five poles within the gap of one pole when compared to the fundamental. Or we can tell the space harmonics will increase the number of poles in the machine. The number of poles will be equal to the order of the harmonic. That means 6k plus or minus 1. It will be equal to 6k plus or minus 1. So what will be the speed of these harmonics? The speed of the harmonics I can calculate, ns is equal to 120 into f divided by the number of poles. Because let us take for example, I am taking the fifth harmonic. So fifth space harmonic will have 5 times the number of poles compared to the fundamental, and it is produced because of the fundamental frequency only. So ns will be equal to 120 into f divided by this poles becomes 5 times of poles, or this will be equal to ns divided by 5. So this is for 5th harmonic. Similarly, ns for the 7th harmonic will be equal to ns divided by 7 and so on. So speed will be less. Now, out of these two harmonics, there are two harmonics. One is 6k plus 1 and second one is 6k minus 1. So let us see what will be the case for the 5th harmonics. So 5th harmonics will rotate at a speed of 1 by 5 times of ns, 1 by 5 times of ns, and if you take the component, so you will observe that that will rotate at an angle. The angle that is subtended will be, because normal is 0, 120 and 240 is the original one. So 5th harmonic we have to multiply with the order of the harmonic. So 0 multiplied by 5 is the displacement. So 5th harmonic is 120 multiplied by 5, and similarly 3rd one will be 240 multiplied by 5. So this becomes 0, 240 and 120. Or otherwise we can tell that the 5th harmonic, if you take the phase sequence, this 5th harmonic phase sequence will be 5A5, this will be 5C5, this will be 5B5. So first A will come, then C will come, you can see 120, and then C comes. And which direction it will rotate? It will rotate in this direction, because ABC sequence is coming in counterclockwise direction. What is the speed of this? Speed of this will be 1 by 5 times of ns. Okay, I am just trying to analyze this. So this can be analyzed like this. The 5th harmonic MMF wave, this will lead to the 5th harmonic flux wave. This 5th harmonic produces the 5th harmonic imaginary poles. It produces the poles which are having the 5 times. So that is the reason that ns becomes ns by 7. Similar is the case if you take the 7th harmonic. 7th harmonic, the displacement will be 0 multiplied by 7, 120 multiplied by 7 and 240 multiplied by 7. If you multiply this by 7, once 360 degrees comes, that can be subtracted. So this becomes 0, 120 and 240. So if you take this, this will be equal to 5A7. The phase sequence is remaining same. So this is 5B7. This will be 5C7. So direction is like this only. This will rotate at 1 by 7 times of ns. Or otherwise, the resultant MMF wave that is produced can be written as 3 by 2 times of f maximum cos of theta minus omega by 7 into t. So it will rotate at a speed of 1 by 7 times of ns. That is the reason. So, or in a general way, I can tell that the harmonics of the order of 6m minus 1, the harmonics of the order of 6m minus 1 always rotate at a speed of 1 by 6m minus 1 times of ns in opposite direction. Opposite direction to your fundamental. Similarly, the harmonics of the order of 6m plus 1 will rotate at a will have the number of speeds, or a speed will be 1 by 6m plus 1 times of ns. This will rotate in the same direction as your fundamental. Same direction as your fundamental. I hope this is clear up to there. So let us try to take one example. So I am taking one example to clarify this. The speed of seventh harmonic wave in a 3-phase 8-pole 50-head synchronous motor is, what is the speed of this? So which direction it will rotate? So this I can solve it like this. This ns is equal to 120 f divided by p. This will be equal to 120 into 5 divided by 8. This becomes 750. So 7th harmonic will be ns is equal to 1 by 7 times of 750. So this will be equal to 107.14 rpm. This is the answer. Okay. Similarly, I can calculate what is the speed of 5th harmonic with respect to fundamental. With respect to fundamental, we know the speed of the 5th harmonic. This is my speed of a fundamental. The speed of the 5th harmonic will rotate at a speed of ns by 5 in opposite direction. So we have to take the relative speed. The relative speed will be adding, the speed will add to each other. This becomes ns plus 1 by 5 times of ns. This becomes 6 by 5 times of ns. Similar way, I can calculate the speed of 7th harmonic with respect to fundamental MMF is. With respect to fundamental, we know both NS and the seventh harmonic. Both will rotate in the same direction. So I have to take the difference. So this becomes NS minus NS by 7. So this becomes 6 by 7 times of NS. So this way you have to calculate. So now we have studied that the space harmonics are coming. They are having a, that they can be defined in a general way as 6k plus or minus 1. That is fine. So how to eliminate this? Let us see how we can make our EMF as sinusoidal, or your flux distribution is sinusoidal. You can make the flux distribution sinusoidal by keeping your this pole shoe in such a way that it is called as chamfered poles. Chamfered poles. So this we have already seen before. In the center, the air gap should be minimum. As we go on, the air gap should be maintained like that, because the MMF is same, because the winding is made here. As the MMF is constant, the MMF should be distributed in the form of a sine wave. In the form of a sine wave. So this is my center. From the center, you can see this is following the cosine wave. So your MMF should follow the cosine wave, or your flux should follow a cosine wave. Flux is equal to MMF divided by reluctance. So this MMF by reluctance from the center should follow cosine wave or cos of the angle. Remember, this theta is in electrical degrees. Or otherwise, because MMF is constant, this 1 by r is proportional to cos theta, or we can tell that the reluctance is inversely proportional to the cos theta. So this reluctance again depends on the air gap. So air gap should be inversely proportional to the cos theta from the center of the pole. So if you are maintaining like that, always automatically your flux distribution becomes sinusoidal. So this problem will be solved. There is another ways. What are the other ways of doing this? You have to make the winding in such a way that the gap between two adjacent slots should be as minimal as possible. When the gap between two adjacent slots are minimum, so automatically the variation of the reluctance, because this flux is going through your slots only, this one here non-uniform is there. If this gap is decreased a lot, then automatically your flux becomes more uniform, or otherwise we have to distribute your slots in such a way there should be as maximum number of slots are possible, so that automatically your flux wave becomes nearly sinusoidal. This is the way you can eliminate your space harmonics. So I hope these topics are clear to you. What is slot harmonics that we have discussed in last class, and what is the space harmonics which we have discussed in this class. So now you will get a doubt. So we have studied that whenever the harmonic is there, that harmonic, whatever the MMF is produced, that is having 120 into whatever is the order of the harmonic. Let us assume fifth harmonic, we have taken as 5f by p. So why we have taken multiplied with frequency there? Why here we are taking as the poles? This doubt will come. Actually, the harmonics that are changing the frequency, these are called as time harmonics. Because we know frequency is nothing but 1 by time period. So whichever is changing the time period of the EMF induced, so that are called as the time harmonics. So time harmonics are, we are not discussing now. We are only discussing about the harmonics that are produced because of constructional details of the machine. So these time harmonics and other things I will discuss once all the basics are done, and when we go for the stability and the other things. Okay. If you still have any queries or any doubts, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.